looking back on the past. I was listening to some music tonight, and I found myself having the most intense regrets of ever paying any attention to music whatsoever. I didn't want to. But it keeps calling you back. It keeps calling you back. I wanted to be through with it. And I got pulled down again by music. And now listening to it now, it's just like, terrible, terrible. Did I really live through those times? What a waste of time. And I found out today that when we don't have the intensity of the spiritual path, which is what our spirit craves, we try to compensate for it by intensity of what? Entertainment, music, sex, drugs, rock and roll sort of thing. We try to compensate for this lack of spiritual intensity. And it doesn't work. And it's a waste of time. So, terrible regrets. Good grief. Just listening to the music and the singers, I say, how could I ever? Why? Now, what's that? There's some rats and creatures moving around here in the nighttime. Wow. What is that? There's some creature. Maybe I'll get a flashlight. Just a minute. Oh, I'm not supposed to get up, that's right. Okay, so there's some... And it just dropped to the ground. Oh well. As long as it's not a skunk. So, testing out this commitment to not get up with all these. Maybe I can trigger the Stay put. But gosh, what a different attitude I have now. Looking back at the past, good Lord. It's like a dream. A very bad dream. Now, we are in phase four, waking up from delusion. And it's may seem very unorthodox. You know, the prevailing sort of teachings in the world are prevailing because they don't work. And people again here don't want teachings to work. They want to follow something that doesn't work. This seems to deal with two situations simultaneously. One, they want to try to satisfy this craving of spirit so it doesn't keep bugging them. And two, they want to make sure that they don't succeed at realizing perfection, realizing the truth. So we have to be occupied with something that doesn't work. So when something comes along that does work, it seems very unorthodox, very unorthodox. I don't exist. I've never existed. Very unorthodox, right? There's nothing to believe. I have no beliefs. I have no accomplishments. I don't exist. I've never existed. Very unorthodox. But it works. It works, it works, it works. Most people would rather do something that's orthodox and fail than doing something unorthodox and succeed. I decided to try out, I went to the driving range today. I haven't been in a long time. I've been working on this sort of swing off the range, just practicing, trying to find a way that doesn't harm my body, because I really can't play any golf anymore because it's causing too much problems in my body. So I figured out a way. I asked the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit suggested, do this, walk through the swing. Don't put all this tension and pressure on the body. Don't torque the body, just as you swing through, just walk the right side through. Just release it and just turn and walk through. And I've been trying it and it works great. So I went out to the range and I was very nervous. I went to the very far end of the range where nobody could see me, I thought. And I started practicing this and it worked great. It worked absolutely great. I was just hitting the ball great. And I don't feel any pain or suffering or misery from that. But it's just super unorthodox. I've never, ever, ever seen anybody swing like that. Never. Gary Player used to do the walkthrough, but this is a kick through almost. Really, I kick my leg out, just really completely make sure there's no torque on the joints at all. So I've never seen anyone do this, but it worked great. Now, will I be able to do that on the golf course? I don't know. If people look at that, they'll say, what in the world is this? Nobody does that that way. But it works, and it prevents, you know, unnatural wear and tear on the hip joints, the back, lower back, and all of that. But it's unlikely to start a trend because people just don't want to do anything that's unorthodox. Similar to this sharing here, we have, we're looking at and we're applying something that seems to be very, very unorthodox, and not many want to even try. Because they're more interested in thinking the image and impression they're making on others. They want to think that others, you know, like the golf swing, they want others to say, oh, it's a good swing. It must be really good. Oh, they hit a bat, the ball wasn't so good. Oh, it's okay, the swing looks good to me. Like the results aren't good, but the swing looks good, so. People want to stay in a very orthodox way that people say, oh yeah, it's very religious, very spiritual. It's great, very righteous person, but the results aren't there. This is a terrible problem we struggle with in this world. Wow. There's a lot of animals out there, just crazy. Climbing all over the place. It's pitch dark, I can't see a thing. That's okay. So I thought my days of playing golf were over forever. And now I'm saying, well, maybe not. Maybe not. And we may think that our spiritual progress is over. Maybe not. We may think, well, I'm not going to make it. Maybe not. Maybe if we keep doing this full stop in the burn, sitting quietly full stop in the burn, I don't exist. I've never existed. Arising, subsiding, and non-arising are all exactly the same, all one. There's no division whatsoever. Christian Dzogchen. Christian Dzogchen. You see, people say, oh, it's very unorthodox, Christian Dzogchen. It's also very effective. You put Jesus Christ and Longchenpa together. It's very effective. So, the path is very difficult just because people expect you to be orthodox, to go along with some script. And if you don't go along with the script, they think that we must be wrong. Inherently so, they don't even bother to look at the content and say, well, off script must be wrong. What they're really saying is on script must be right. But who said the script they're on is right? Is it effective? Just because others do it doesn't mean it's effective. So let there be light, let there be light, let there be light, let there be light. Now, I don't know if I can use that swing on the course with other people there or something. I don't know. I don't really know. Problem is, you'll have to hit it perfect every time for them to say, well, maybe it works. Or they'll just say, no, it's lucky, just lucky. See, if you go off script, people will insist that you must be doing something wrong. You must be wrong. So it doesn't matter how right you are, you're never going to be right. If you don't do it the way that they expect you to do it, then, you know, it's just lucky. Just lucky. And if you do it on script, they'll say, oh, yeah, he's good. They're good. That's good. Yeah, really good. Well, it didn't work. Well, that's okay. They did it the right way. It stayed on script. That's okay. So, of course, you're going to hit some bad shots. And then they'll immediately say, ah, you see, it's the unorthodoxy that's causing this. And I say, well, hey, actually, I'm hitting it better now than I am doing the orthodox swing, which I can do perfectly well. Plus, I'm saving my body. But you'll never convince people. You simply will not. So don't bother trying to convince people of anything. Just do your practice and just succeed. That's all. Just make sure you get into spiritual intensity every day. Have to do it. Now, this was unexpected intensity here with all these animals crawling and climbing and dropping in the ground. I don't know what was going on. It's thing like you want to get up and say, no. See, it's kind of like a primal thing that's scary. Pitch darkness, I can't see what's going on. around me. But, so you know, when I say I'm going to sit, I'm going to sit. I'm not going to get up for any reason. Not going to get up for that either. So I put a lot of intensity into this. So, whatever we've done to try and bring spiritual intensity in our lives that's not spiritual intensity is not good news. However, we've tried to stagger ourselves with something other than spiritual truth, we should repudiate it. I repudiate all that waste of time, completely repudiate it. Absolutely. I thank God, the one who was struggling and trying not to listen to all that music and spend all that time that way, and succumbed, had hope that one day they would be able to repudiate it. So this is a great day to be able to repudiate all that. There was something that said, one day I'm going to get free of this. One day I'll look back on all this and I'll say, you know what? I didn't really want to do that at all. One day I'll have the strength to not be pulled into that. So these are the great battles that are in life. My life has been like a ceaseless great battle. So many campaigns, so many battles, just almost numberless, and struggling against entropy into dualistic delusion, struggling against the continuity fear, pulling me down. But how else to live life? Might as well be a spiritual warrior. Go to battle every day. Try to break the bad habits. Try to evaporate the continuity fear. Try to find the answer. I don't know any accomplishments whatsoever. All is devoid of accomplishment. I see no accomplishment anywhere. Except the giants. Except the giants. No exceptions. No exceptions. I'll have to work on that one too. yeah, absolutely. Exceptions, no exemptions, no exceptions, no exceptions, no exceptions, no exemptions, no accomplishments. But generally, you need to at least act as if you acknowledge accomplishments in this world, or people will think you're too weird. So that's fine. When in Rome, do as Romans do, to a certain extent. And that too is just an example of trying to get some sort of depth of intensity, staggering the mind, compensating for non-spiritual, not spiritual intensity. When in doubt, sit quietly like this. When in doubt, when you don't know what to do, when you're in doubt, when you're down, when sit quietly like this. Collect your thought, collect your, say, I don't have a doubt problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a confusion problem, I have a continuity problem. I'm not a body, I am free, I am spirit. I'm still spirit as God created me. I'm not a body, I am free, I am still spirit as God created me. I do not have a confusion problem, I have a continuity problem. I do not have a difficulty problem, I have a continuity problem. I do not have a success problem, I have a continuity problem. So sit quietly, work to center yourself. This is the way. Distraction really doesn't work well. Saw somebody today, and a young person seems as though they may have like a methamphetamine problem. The way they act and the face and stuff is going on, it's like, wow. Lots of young people, you know, what are you, terrible, right? What do you do? I don't have a methamphetamine problem, I have a continuity problem, see? So we need to get our attention on the continuity problem and get interested in it. And when we get interested in that, the other stuff falls away. We don't need it. So my advice is do not attack your problems directly. But my advice is to insist you don't have those problems. You have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem you have. It's very severe. But you do have it. Very severe, but you do have it. And get interested in the continuity problem, working on it. And then you will find your interest in the other stuff just drops away. So meth addicts, they'll find that they're really not interested in it anymore. It's just boring. It just doesn't really fulfill me. This continuity problem is way more interesting. It is absolutely the most interesting focus there can be. Wow, what is it that's holding me back? What is it that I'm afraid of? What is it, you know? See? More commotion out there. Get interested in the continuity problem. Get interested in sitting quietly and working on it. And it will be the most interesting endeavor anyone could ever have, for sure. Just the capacity to assert what you've not been able to assert before is just a mind blower, just staggers the mind. Just to say, I have never existed. I have never, ever existed. And to believe it. And you know, what happens is you look back in the past, you see how the world had a hold of your attention. And you realize, wow, how terrible that was. What a waste of time. Awful. And this is what the whole world is going into now. That's why I say it's such a terrible time. It's global distraction. Globalization of distraction to an intense amount of level. And it's just unconscionable. whole planet of everybody just simply doing nothing, wasting their time. It's just unconscionable. The great guru should be here saying, don't forget me. Don't forget me. Don't forget what I stand for. Don't forget the spiritual intensity. Don't analyze why people are, you know, pulled down too much. Just make sure you're not pulled down. So just take it. What's that smell? Wow, weird stuff going on. Just take it that, very bad smell. What is going on out there in the world? Just take it that the great teachers are here simply to promote in spiritual intensity. That's it. Just let them promote it. Just feel it. So Jesus shows up. Just say, okay, I know exactly why you're here. Promote spiritual intensity in my day. All right, let's do it. Don't demand anything more. Just accept what they have to offer. It's like a musician, you expect that they're going to promote, you know, musical intensity in your life when you listen to their song or something. Well, like the great teachers, they promote spiritual intensity in your life, in your day. Bring the spiritual intensity into play. Sit quietly so you can absorb it. I'll pray for some breakthrough here. Spend some time focusing on that. Forget about everything else. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. And just feel the intensity of I don't exist. So we'll see if we can get the presence of some teacher, great teacher here. If we can get some, up the intensity. This is where I'm at now. Up the intensity. Now I know people like drink caffeine products to up the intensity, right? But I'm trying to say we don't need that. I think we're doing great right now, up in the intensity. I do not exist. I have never existed. Existence. There is no existence. There is no existence whatsoever. That's pretty intense. Don't need coffee for that. I think people are crying out for spiritual intensity. That's why they do all this other stuff. Try to get that sense of intensity. It doesn't work. Only the real thing works. Only the genuine thing works. I remember first time I saw Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, that just absolutely floored me. I couldn't speak for like a half an hour. I was stammering and sobbing, stammering and sobbing, and just came unglued. The intensity was so off the charts. Just beyond my belief system entirely. So I just couldn't account for it through belief at all. That's great. That's tremendous. said, hey, what the world needs, they need that intensity. They need the intensity. Because they're desperately searching for the intensity in some way. People are like climbing mountains and rock climbing. I mean, the bungee jumping. There's a thrill-seeking generation, an intensity-seeking generation. They're so desperate for intensity. And I'm saying none of that will work for you until you get spiritual intensity. That's what actually works. That's why I'm not skydiving or bungee jumping or doing all this stuff. As I got more intensity to that than that by, you know, can't even measure it, compare it, actually. When you realize that you don't exist and have never existed, I try that for intensity. When you have this experience of this massive space vehicle turn itself over just right in front of you, it's just, you know, riveting intensity. When you get a glimpse of the vision of oneness, there's no skydiving. You have these people go up in helium balloons now or skydiving from high distance. Now again, compensation. Get a glimpse of the vision of oneness and then talk about intensity. I tried to produce the most intense music possible when I was younger. Forget it, isn't it? You can never, never produce any music that's even remotely comparable to the intensity of a glimpse of the vision of oneness, the holy instant. Holy instant. Wow. So we need a culture of spiritual seeking spiritual intensity on a daily basis. Forget all the other stuff. Forget about it. You won't even be interested in it. People try to get intensity through relationships too, right? Through relationships. Forget it. You see, the vision of oneness has no relationship can hold a candle to that. It's like a candle to the sun. No. You have these dyadic relationships and all this kind of stuff. No. Vision of oneness, you see. Nothing has ever existed. We are all one family, one perfect, perfect family, one perfect family with no exclusions, no exceptions, no exemptions, nothing to prove, nothing to believe in, nothing to accomplish. Totally safe, totally perfect, all loving, all. Absolutely radiating gratitude and happiness and bliss. All directions, you know, this is the vision of oneness. It's already the case. See, that's the intensity you want, so. Don't waste the time, you won't waste your time on all this other stuff, really. Sit still, sit quiet, practice, practice, practice. Let there be light, 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 let there be light. All right, so. there be light, let there be light, let there be light, let there be light. Let there be light, let there be light, let there be light, let there be light, let there be light. So, spiritual path is where it's at. That's a responsible life. This is what the ancient cultures, there has been a transmission throughout the ages of those who know this. And, of course they don't waste their time with other stuff. This modern world here is an abomination. It's an absolute abomination. It's an attempt to say, oh, we can compensate. We can find another way. We don't have to have the spiritual intensity. We can find intensity some other way. And think that the flesh is our identity, and that feeding the flesh with intensity is somehow going to will satisfy us. It absolutely does not, never will. And you will regret all the wasted time, but you will also someday be able to repudiate it, which will be a great day for you. I repudiate everything I've ever done to try and compensate. So I stand in perfect repudiation of all the false effort, all the delay. So let there be light, 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 let there be light. I remember when I was about 23, 22, so depressed, such an extremely bad situation, and a high school friend came to visit me. And his what he was telling me, he said, "Hey, stop worrying about other people, what other people think about you. Forget it. To heck with it." And he just kept saying that, and it left this lasting impression on me. Helped change my life. I started to stop worrying so much about what other people thought about me, one way or the other. And now I try not to think about it at all. It just doesn't cross my mind. It doesn't matter what I think of them, what they think of me. Bottom line is, better do your spiritual practice no matter what. So you do your spiritual practice and don't worry about others. Let them do what they do. It's not your problem. Just take care of your own life. Make sure you do it. Your business very well. All right. Let there be light, 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 let there be light. who knows when something more breakthroughs will come. Certainly they're needed. Certainly they'll be intense. But that's what it's all about. Don't force the intensity. Never force the intensity. Just stay calm, quiet, poised, meek, humble. Repentant. And it will arise, it will arise. The breakthroughs will arise. So, we'll see what happens next. That's it.